Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 23, Environment and Sustainable Development. And our topic is Sustainable Development, the Divergent View. There were more than 160 countries that had participated in the proceedings of the conference, and there were definitely at least more than 480 agenda items in circulation at the venue of the conference. There were 160 proposals tabled on the official representatives of the respective states. Then there was another set of 160 proposals that were overtly or covertly expressed through the voice of dissent in the respective states. There was yet another set of 160 proposals that were articulated by the non-government organizations of every country. So, it was decidedly one of the most difficult tasks before the UN to arrive at a consensus on such a contentious issue. However, the most significant line of discord emerged between the perspective of the developed and the developing country on sustainable development. Let us discuss the perspective of the developed world. The developed countries continue to hold their privileged position and were not willing to compromise on anything, because they were of the opinion that this will prove detrimental to maintain high standard of living in these countries. In fact, they blamed the increasing populations among poorer countries as a serious threat to the global environment. They approach sustainable development from the point of view of restoring pollution-free environment for a healthy living. Now let us discuss the perspective of the developing countries. As opposed to this, the perspective of the developing countries showed a diametrically opposite picture. According to this view, the hegemonic control of the developed world over the trade, environment, resources, economy, technology, knowledge and politics, etc., is the single most important threat to the global environment, peace and development. They need a safe and protective environment because it is the basis of their individual and social survival. It was felt that with increasing destruction of environment due to the ongoing developed projects, mostly launched by the developed world, there have been phenomenal increase in the incidence of poverty, starvation and hunger in the post-colonial countries. This is an apprehension among the developing countries that in the name of liberalization, globalization and privatization, the world capitalism is out to reconstruct the colonies. But this time the new colonies are not only restricted to the geographical spaces, but also cover the processes of colonization of organism and life itself. The environment and the indigenous communities inhabiting the post-colonial countries are also under the threat in the new patent regime for want of adequate technology available with them. Thus, the question of environment and sustainable development in case of developing countries is intricately related to retaining their freedom, identity and existence. Now let us move to the next point, working list of indicators of sustainable development. Apart from the above issues, the other contentious issue was how to measure sustainable development. Or in other words, what are the indicators of sustainable development? Once again, it was difficult to arrive at a consensus on the nature as well as number of indicators to be selected for measuring sustainable development. The Economic and Social Commission for Asia and Pacific under the auspices of United Nations prepared a working list of indicators of sustainable development. It was done under the program of work on indicators of sustainable development of the Commission on Sustainable Development, CSD. It is evident from the list of indicators suggested that the sustainable development is possible only a holistic, multi-pronged approach. Any single approach that was suggested by many scholars falls short of what is minimum for the maintenance of quality of life and prosperity of environment. Take for example the economic approach to sustainable development propounded by the Hicks Lindha. Emphasis on the generating maximum flow of income while maintaining the stock of assets. The underlying assumption of this approach is to improve the economic efficiency of resources that are scarcely available. It takes other associated factors as given. As opposed to this, the ecological approach emphasizes on the stability of the biological and physical systems and above all on the sustainability of a global ecosystem, protection of biodiversity, etc. This approach too gives peripheral importance to other intervening factors. There is yet another approach popularly known as the socio-cultural approach, which emphasizes on the maintenance of socio-cultural systems, including reduction of destructive conflicts. According to the protagonist of this approach, preservation of cultural diversity across the globe is a prerequisite for sustainable development. Once again, this approach too failed to comprehend the issue in its totality. A critical look at all these approaches therefore suggests, instead of one approach, we should talk of a set of approaches, because technology does undergo change over generation. Thus, considering all these points, the list of indicators suggested by United Nations Economic and Social Commission appear to be more acceptable than any other approach. Now let us sum up the unit. Sustainable development has become a catchword because it is directly linked to the survival of human beings, their civilization and the very environment of which they are an inseparable part. In the name of the so-called development, there are large-scale deforestation, atmospheric changes such as thinning down of life-saving ozone layer, loss of biodiversity, growing volume of waste that are becoming unmanageable day by day. Moreover, human actions have caused poisoning of the life supporting system of our environment, namely soil, air, water and organism. What is more surprising than all these is that the economic gains made at such a huge social and environmental cost are restricted to the minuscule minority of the world population. Large section of world's population continues to live in perpetual poverty, hunger and starvation. Millions of people world over are dying every year for want of basic necessities of their life. Coexistence of opulence and squalor at one and the same time is also breeding new form of social tensions and violence. Terrorism, one of the extreme form of violence, is essentially an unlawful activity of the victims of unilateral global hegemony. Therefore, sustainable development, if attended properly, holds the key to development with social justice and environmental conservation. This is also the key to safe future for the mankind. Now let us wind up the session, and we have come to the end of the unit. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.